1,000 Americans are living with hemophilia. It is a condition that prevents blood from clotting easily after a cut or an injury. Patients are also more susceptible to internal bleeding. Well, now researchers are now testing gene therapies for both types of hemophilia, type A and type B.
Little Hunter Miller's motor is always running. Like most toddlers, he's sometimes one step away from trouble.
Come on.
But for Hunter, being rough and tumble can have serious side effects. Hunter has severe hemophilia. 3 days after he was born, a routine circumcision caused a major scare.
You know, baby gets up in the morning, their diapers are just full. Well, his was full, but it was full of blood.
Mama. Doctors diagnosed Hunter with hemophilia A, which means his blood is missing a protein known as clotting factor 8. When he gets hurt, doctors need to inject the clotting factor to stop the bleeding. He's had 8 emergency room visits in just 19 months.
Him falling, bumping his head too hard, just little cuts. He's cutting the roof of his mouth just with a tortilla chip. And that was a hospital trip.
Dr. Catherine Ponder studies gene therapy treatment for hemophilia and other blood disorders. Her lab treated hemophilia in animals, but she says the therapy isn't quite ready for humans just yet.
I think that the big question is going to be the safety.
But gene therapy has proven effective for some patients with hemophilia B. Researchers at St. Jude Children's Hospital and University College of London have added the missing protein, factor 9, to a specially engineered virus, which travels to the patient's liver and transfers the gene.
This modifies their disease from a situation where they might bleed once a week to a situation where they hardly ever bleed.
1, 2, 3.
Until there's a cure, Heather walks a fine line between hovering and helping Hunter develop like any other 2-year-old.
You don't want to put him in a bubble.
Dr. Ponder says regular treatments of clotting factor can help keep hemophilia under control, but are often very costly. Those treatments can run upwards of $300,000 a year.